This lesson is from Canada, where I was and I'm still the chairman of the board of management of Islamic Relief in Canada. And we submitted a project proposal for funding for humanitarian forum. And the law does not allow me to be in the meeting where they discuss the issue of such project because I would have a vested interest. And we did not receive any comment on the funding proposal for months. And I had a phone call from one of the colleagues in the board saying that it's very strange. The amount of money that you are asking for is not very much. The project is very strategic. And people are asking for voting, and most probably they will say no. What you told me, shall I talk on your behalf? I said, no, it's entirely up to you. If you would like to do it independently. And said, can you talk to the board? I said, no, I can't, because I am the chairman. And she kept telling me, you want me to talk to them? I said, it's entirely up to you. I'm not going to interfere. It's your own issue. Then she kept calling me, telling me, can you talk to them, please? I said, no, I would not talk to them. And after a few days, she sent me a few messages saying that she talked to the individuals in the board to explain to them the strategic direction of such a conference and how important that we need to support it and to fund it. Because of its value, its moral value, social value, and empowering value, especially for the small organization. And they agreed at the end of the day. Lesson learned, number one, is don't just run for the money. Even with the closest of your friends, colleagues, or relatives. Don't use your power, your political power, because you are the chairman, to gain benefit for your other organization. Don't use side other avenues, lobbying, to pressurize the board members. Be sympathetic with the other board members who might be very busy, didn't have much time to read. That's why they might not be able to understand the value of your project. Know for sure that the decision is in the hand of Allah. And he is the one who will put the decision on the tip of the tongues of the board members. But he is the one who decides in his kingdom what to do and what you do on his behalf. That's why by doing this, you'll understand that actually we are judging in the kingdom of God with the judgment of God, not with our judgment. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.